it over to Glenn Breed and staff for F-12 budget discussion.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman and Council, for coming in early this morning. Seems like we're meeting a couple of times a week now. We're going to cover a lot of information today, and you'll see an additional face that probably looks a lot better than me and Jim in the name of Linda Blackaby. She's going to be talking a little bit about her discussions with some of the park staff about their budget and relay and convey to you what we propose, and I think you'll be interested in hearing that. Our first bit of information is going to come from Jim related to the employee health insurance. We'll talk about obviously the self-insurance plan that we've had some interesting discussion about, some more information that we've learned on the state health plan, and some other items for your consideration. And then we'll talk about a detailed discussion about the Parks and Recreation recommended budget, where the proposed budget stood, and where we're recommended it go. And then we've got some additional house cleaning items that we'll deal with and present to you that are pretty minor. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Jim, and we'll have the health insurance first.
Thank you, Glenn. Mr. Chairman, members of council, we're back again with health insurance. You asked very wisely, Mr. Chairman, about our claims experience, and we've looked at that in detail over the past 4 years, and here you have it. And as you can see, this is an April figure for the current year, but the number here is up, the number here is up, and obviously the number premiums are less than claims paid. What that means is this is the driver of all of our conversations, the driver of our discussions about buying stop-loss insurance if we go to self-funded, the driver of our discussions with Blue Choice if we stay on our same plan, the concern if this continues about if we get on the state plan, what will our load factor look like. So as we talk about, remember that these are pretty okay and don't show a lot of change, but this one is driving our conversation. So we continue to try to look at the proposal to go to self-insurance. We've tweaked some numbers for you, some ongoing discussions, and I appreciate very much Ted Eastler and Tony Bell working through this. Last meeting, this number was $9.50 per month per employee, so we negotiated that one down. We tried to work on this one, the retention of the network services at 10%. Blue Choice simply says they're not going any lower than that. They value the network, the community, the healthcare community values that network, and there's no argument that that's the best network. So that drives costs. And then our stop loss coverage, your reaction last time was look at what Blue Choice is doing here. We had, this was $175,000 last time, so we asked to look at $125,000. This was $1,825,000, and so we asked to look at $1,875,000 maximum per year per participant. And then at the aggregate, we reduced this number by just over $1 million. So what does that do? That number last time was $896,000. So it drives cost again. And back to my first slide, the reason that this is higher than we would like for it to be is because they all see that experience that we've had in the current year. And then the open question is the establishment of the reserve. Obviously, I can get all kind of experts or consultants to give us some guidance there. The first year is somewhat critical, but really critical is going forward and our diligence in maintaining a reserve once we get it established and continuing to contribute to it. You've seen this slide before. This one hadn't changed. So what we're proposing is to keep the employees as they are today with their per paycheck premium. Well, that's what we're trying to do with the self-funded look. We had some further discussions with the state plan. As most of you know, you can learn a whole lot now on websites, but there's not much substitution for face-to-face conversation. So I've talked to one of their persons who deals with all the local government entities. As of July 1, there'll be 37 of the 46 South Carolina counties that will participate in the plan. They have worked to be sure that they are grandfathered for the 2014 health care provisions. Either way we go, that's an important step to take. And that's about plan design, and we'll need to be careful with that with our self-funded, if that's the way we go as well. We did talk in detail about enrollment. We have the potential to enroll in October, but they suggest that if we make a decision that we enroll in January, which will mean we'll need to retain Blue Choice from July 1 to January 1 if we accept this option. Their rates and are based on all of our calculations to date on their current rates, but they finalize rates on October 1. So that's what will be applied to this January 1 date. And all of the estimates I've used, as I said, have been based on current year numbers. So the savings there will not be quite as much as what you've seen in the past, is a short way to say that. I got some more detail on their experience loading. The first 2 years, the experience loading for us will be based on all of the new users that go in for the current year. One of the reasons they're pushing us for the January 1 date is that they're overwhelmed with new entities joining their program. Part of it is the municipal pool is no longer exists. So July 1 of this year, they're going to have 76 new members. Their average over the last few years is less than 20. So we'll be in that group as far as the first 2 years about our loading. And then after that, it will be based on our individual group statistics. And then the annual cap you asked about, there is a maximum set that will be reset on October 1. This year, no group participating reached the cap. So we gave you the example in our discussions of Darlington County. Their increase the current year is 20%. That didn't reach the cap. So the cap is pretty conservative or pretty high as they go forward. And they do have, I think I said last time that they didn't encourage, weren't doing anything to encourage wellness. They are instituting some new programs that actually our county health clinic could and would benefit from if we chose to participate in there. And this, just the additional information you heard, Lindsey Brady's comments last time about past participation in the state health program. There are 16 or 17 entities in Spartanburg County who are participants in this program in the state plan. And from the participant's point of view, what happens there is almost like where we were when we initially presented the Blue Choice options going forward to you, in that
the deductibles are not large. I think it's $350. But each participant pays the total $350 before they get any benefit. So it's not like a copay. You're going to pay $350 before you start achieving any benefit at all from the program. And that's their standard plan. And again, they have other options, but the other options have larger deductibles. So that's part of what you'll hear from participants, is that it's not first dollar insurance like we have now. And again, we looked at comparable counties, and you can take, I think I gave you the wrong counties last time. Charleston and York County participate in the state plan. Greenville and Richland County are self-funded programs. And each of them would stand here and tout the benefits of where they are, is the bottom line. They think they've made the right choice for several different reasons. As the guys from COG said last time, every group is different. So I guess that gets us to where we are. And we've discussed this at some length, both with Ted and Tony, Linda and Glenn. I guess I see it probably two different ways this morning. If we choose to go to self-funded, we need to be really, really critical about that reserve, and we're not in a position today or on July 1st to get there. So if we do that, what we would recommend is that we take a 6-month period from July to January and allow us to receive some quotes and take some bids, if you will, on the aggregate and stop loss going forward, and even look at other TPAs and other networks and see what that may bring us. Or the other option, and continue an analysis of the state plan while we're there. The other option would be to accept Blue Choice as we have today without the enhanced plan for a 6-month period as we continue to analyze all of this and come to you with a recommendation that would become effective January 1 for us and all of our employees. That experience from the current year is driving some cost and driving some concerns about what our reserves properly need to be, and I can't stand here and tell you how we would best fund it. I apologize for that, but that's the best pleasure we can get this morning.